Yeah, no, I forgot. I was recording speedruns on Discord, so I don't tend to record microphone or headset. So, cheers for that. What are we doing? I don't have this menu. How you doing, Dev? Your little brother can still pull off some Pokémon. Current standing none. I hand off the control till I select the right one. Like, I'm torn between this one, which should have had the Lapras in there. And this one should have air balloon on the Raichu. And then, of course, the one I'm deciding on. All three of them I really love. But for best of one, like, I really, really, really would want to use this one. Honestly, pretty much same. Day in, day out, same thing. There's only so much chemistry I can care about. Anyway, we're doing this. Just to make sure. Oh, so there is a 45-second delay on, so if anyone tries to stream snipe me, I cannot. Their turn will be over by the time, more or less, I'm done deciding my turn. So that's just a precaution, but in general, it's not a bad thing to have for this. I do random music. I never like always having just one simple music each time. Person. Hans Duo. It's like he has one single win. Hardcore Trick Room team, Malamar. I don't mind this. Don't mind this at all. Can't really do too much if I set up Lapras off the start. And whatever he pairs with. Am I doing Hitmontop Lapras lead? Because his team's slow. Chlorophyll Leafeon's there for speed control and Sunny Day. That's why the Torkoal's there as well, but it's also a Trick Room team because Hatterene's on there. Top Pokemon. Yeah, I think we're gonna go Lapras. He also has. Well, he's already decided. We'll do Lapras, Hitmontop, Elcremie, and. Honestly, we could do Togekiss, or we could do Gengar. One of the two. Yeah, I feel that. You know what? We're gonna go for Clefairy. We're gonna go for the support. Again, not used to having a delay, but you know, better. I take a picture of the trading cards. Ah, he has the Pokeball shirt. Okay, so he's going to be switching out into Torkoal. So I am going to. Thankfully, the Intimidate is double effective because obviously I'm hitting both physical attackers. I'm gonna G-Max into Leafeon, and I am going to probably just go for the. What happened there? Was the. I think the Hitmontop Sandstorm came after. Even if I'm slower, if he Dynamaxes, he's going to lose his Tyranitar. I'm still going to hit the... what's it called? Yeah, here comes... Oh! I mean, sure. I don't even mind that. Like, he has the minus one, so even if he were to kind of deck me, it's not really the worst case scenario. Oh, shiny shinies? Well, Leafeon's definitely faster than Lapras, because that's how the Dynamaxing works. For the same turn, shows which one's faster. At least for that turn, I think in the speed tie it counts as well. If I recall the cut. So I want to figure out what to do with the bottom part of my layout. I honestly can't figure out. I got the team. I made sure I grabbed that. Should be ish. Yeah. Ah, it's life orb. I was gonna say that did a lot of damage for. So we're going to be setting up Aura Veil. Get rid of that thing. That's why I'm not really too worried about it, because since I went into it, the damage is going to be massive. So. They want to try to go on me. I got a very, very, very defensive team. So. And I have Bullet Punch on this Pokemon, so... And Hatterene is definitely going to be slower. And if Tyranitar comes out, I can... I guess I can go for... Okay. I mean, I don't mind this. What can I do here? If I set up this, like the reveal on barring a critical hit should protect Lapras. So we will, yeah, we'll just do this and then we will bullet punch to Hatterene. The logic here is super effective damage, low physical attack. Really? Weakness policy. Neat. I did not expect that. I mean, cool. Why is that such low defense? Or why is that such low damage? I don't mind that. Maybe we got one last turn of Max Guard here. And then... Things are extremely bulky for. Like, I'm really tempted to switch out into Clefairy. No. Yeah, no, I'm gonna switch out into Clefairy so I get the. Friend Guard support for next turn afterwards, because the grassy terrain is going to heal me again. But, yeah, okay, I wasn't going to care about that. That's fine. I just wanted, yeah, and you're using that. I'm kind of going to do the dumb and go for the protect. I'm going to bio an extra turn and I'm just going to go for a blind sing onto Torkoal because I don't want to try to sing the magic bounce Hatterene there. I never thought it'd be a weakness policy one. That really is cool. Yeah, now it's just gonna be spamming the wide stuff. Much as I want to use Parasong, I'm going to go for a Hydro Pump and I'm going to go for the Fake Out. Yeah. I'm going to get another Fake Out again here. I think I lost this one because of that damn weakness policy. I did not expect a Hatterene to have weakness policy. Which is really cool. I never conceived to have that. But I will check after the match is done what the hell its defense stat is. That's actually really cool. So I didn't think... I thought... Oh wow, no, that thing has a lot more defense than I thought it did. Holy crap. That, no, that's something I knew other than new, so. I'm just gonna call this one basically. I've basically died. Cool though. I'm just gonna forfeit. I lost this one. I'm 100% fair. Wow, the thing is 95 base defense though. I honestly thought it was a brittle. I gotta look into that then. That's fun. I wanna do all 45 this weekend, but university and stuff. Should have taken the Trick Room threat more seriously. Gotta pronounce that one. You got Screams, you got G-Max, Lapras, you got, I can't remember, is this one? This is, Serene Grace, yeah. You got Serene Grace, you got... I mean, I could go my normal route. Yeah, we're just gonna do these two for start. We're gonna do Ocreamy in the back, and I don't like Pokemons, indeed. Gengar would be good. Problem is with. I mean, I could activate the weakness policy with Ocreamy too. No, Akrimi's not fast enough. I need to have this as a lead. How you doing, Horza? Second is a 45 second delay, so. I don't like Clefairy in this matchup, because everything's either spread or does whatever. I'm going Togekiss. I should go Gengar, but I don't see the Mimikyu. I don't see the rest of the team being too much problematic, because my team's a bit meh. That's a really good one, I like that. I have to try to remember to take pictures each time. Ah, someone also has a Great Ball Lapras. I appreciate that. Okay, we got to Intimidate. Going for Fake Out, obviously, onto Grimmsnarl there. We're just going to double up into it. Then we're going to, after this, if he hits Hitmontop. Yep, there's the Lapras. Ohio indeed. Okay, looks like I'm slower. This is going to be a very drawn out match. Because there's going to be two sets of Aurovil going out, and if it's also on their side as well. Yeah, it's going to be a whole hell of a lot of this, basically. Just two Aurora Veils is going against each other, basically. You know, we're gonna go for El Creamy, though. I see your Grimmsnarl, and I raise you a Grimmsnarl. A shame that mine isn't faster, but I'm pretty sure if they're going this route, theirs probably would be more of a like a glass can style 252 build. See, if they set up Orville, it means this thing's going to be coming out with some pretty annoying things. So I'm actually going to go Max Guard. I don't want to do a paralysis. That's the thing. You know, I'm gonna bank on it though. And we're gonna decorate my Lapras. Hey, Nick. Thank you, it's still a work in progress. Wait, is that Lair? Does Lightscreen or Orville actually Lair? If so, that's terrifying. I still have no idea what to put on the bottom though. Didn't look like it. Yeah, they definitely have a faster Lapras if it does being my El Creamy. So they have basically no defensive stats. And I am going to G-Max Resonance into that thing. And I am going to... Honestly, if I decorate again, that wouldn't be a bad thing. But I could switch out to Hitmontop. And if he doubles up in Lapras, I can survive and I have Fake Out Pressure for the next turn. Yeah, we're going to do that. Then Togekiss can come in and be annoying afterwards. There's also, again, in case you don't know, Nick, there's a 45 second delay on. So. That's fine. Okay, mine's a defensive build. I'm actually gonna go to Togekiss here. I know I'm faster. Or if not, I'll survive. But I am going to be going for the plus two freeze dry into Lapras here. And then I will be going for Choice Scarf. A Choice Scarf Dazzling Gleam to take out the... That was Choice Banded. Yeah, there you go. We'll get rid of that. That's the main thing. I don't want that surviving. Especially in the rain. Ooh. Let's see. That's fine. So, what I can do here... Ooh, you also got a little one. I will freeze dry, and I will break the freeze by using... I can't because of the damn thing. Okay, new plan. We're going to use Parish Song. And we are going to switch out to all creamy. Oh, you do that. That's fine. I don't mind that. Ooh, hey, you did not have a... All these effects and more. Yeah, it says lightning, light screen still on there, so... Anyway, we'll freeze dry. Actually, it's in the rain. No, we'll freeze dry and Giga Drain. Because we have the extra reveal right now. That shouldn't kill. That's annoying. Well, that's pretty much game then. I am gonna do one last kind of not bad thing to do. But I will switch out to Togekiss and I will decorate that slot. Because then I can use Heat Wave, break the freeze with a plus two on a single target as well out of the rain. I like my little creamies. Like, that's not gonna kill either, yeah. Now we're going to use Heat Wave, and we're going to Mystical Fire. Really? I thought Heat Wave would break it, because it's... Oh no, it has Scald, I think. Eh, whatever. We'll lower the special attack. That should guarantee a survival, and both Alcremies are going to drop dead. There you go. GG. The paralysis didn't kick in. Or if the paralysis did kick in, I would have a lot more issues. But... Just stationary toke, yes. That's fun. I like that. Alcremie showed its weight there. Lapras, Parasong. Instead of the Thunder variant, is very nice. Togekiss was stationary. Elmo. I guess I should be singing that, basically. Okay, so you got the Intimidate Incineroar, the Gardevoir, which is kind of interesting. Bragapult. I mean, all things considered, it is a Trick Room team, because obviously the Duskwar's there, and then you got kind of like two or three variants. I'm not too sure about the Gardevoir for being slower. But I mean, nice thing we can do. Yeah, a 45 second delay. Okay, so what we can do here is this was I should change the delay in that browser thing as well, so properly. Anyway. There's nothing to stop me from doing Alcremie and Hitmontop with Lapras in the back. And I want to say Clefairy, but I like Togekiss a lot. So go Togekiss. Well, they're having a lot of problems deciding as well. Let me turn off the... I think I turned off the delay? I don't know. This might not be worth it. So what we're going to be doing is max overgrowth and a bullet punch. Because we're going to basically try to nuke that Lapras before it has a chance to set up. And if it uses Trick Room after, then they have to deal with Alcremie with G-Max form. I don't know if that turned it off or not. Oh, no, it's that one. Yeah, whatever. If there's a delay, there's a delay. I'm still recording, so technically I can just... Oh, whatever. Not worth the effort. Okay, that's a good sign, because unless they're Dynamaxing the Dusclops, I don't have to worry about it. Oh, I forgot to get a picture of the trading card. Damn it. We're gonna get the Bullet Punch into Alcremie. We're going to activate the weakness policy, and since we Dynamax first, we know we're faster, and we're going to try to nuke that poor Lapras out of the water with the max overgrowth. Which is not the case. Test? 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 Yeah, there's a weakness policy. I knew that was coming up. It's kind of annoying. Fine, though. But here comes Trick Room. That's the problem. So I'm going to max guard, and I am going to close combat into that, and hopefully... That's annoying. Ah, you got the Plumpa. I mean, I can just go for G-Max Finale into this slot, and if he uses it again, I can basically nuke him out of the water in close combat. Yeah, we're just going to close combat into... Actually, the Ghost. I'm predicting the ally switch. Hopefully, Creamy can survive. I don't think it can. Max Geyser, maybe. No. Okay. Well, we predicted the... Okay, definitely not the critical. That's annoying. But we did call the close combat, though. Ooh. Crash, bang, boom down there. Well, he has a defensive build with the R-Veil up. How many turns of Trick Room left? Two. So I could... You know, I will Hydro Pump into that slot. And I will Sucker Punch. I'll Bullet... Yeah, I will Freeze Dry... Is he gonna do another ally switch when I just called it? Yeah, I'm gonna freeze dry into that slot, and I'm sorry, Hydro Pump into that slot, and Bullet Punch into that one. That's fine. That's not fine. That's gonna hurt. That's pretty annoying. Problem is I have, one turn of Trick Room left. What about them? How many? Potentially one room of, or one thing of that. So this is my final move for the game. So I'm gonna go for Dazzling Gleam. And then I'm gonna go Sucker Punch, I guess. That should target the Lapras, right? Yeah. Interesting. Okay, I'm dead basically, but I learned something there, is that you can use okay, that's not... Sorry, I meant to unplug my webcam. Because OBS likes to make it the default microphone. Wait, where do you sucker punch on an ally switch slot? That means I'll still hit, so I learned something. And just as a thing, can I take out Lapras with a bullet pump for damage? Yes. Okay, so one for Orville. Yeah. I'm super dead, for the record. I'm sending his bullet punch into it, though. Yeah, I have the chat open so I can see any new people come in. But... really? Just... I mean, I guess? I'm gonna predict some bad manners, so I'm gonna go sucker punch onto Dustbumps there. This is great. What the player is doing is cycling Trace Intimidates over and over and over again to lower my attack. That's actually funny. I guess if you know how to do that. No? No. GG to that opponent, that was a lot of fun. I did learn about the ally switch sucker punch thing, so it's not like it's a... not dead. I'm just gonna click a button. If it stops streaming, just refresh. Okay, there we go. There you go. I no longer have a delay. I'll take that off for now. Sorry, there's a button. Oh. Killed the stream by accident. That's my bad. Eight. I wonder if it's doing that because of the. I have to kill it. Alright, one sec. Why is it in Texas? There we go. There we go. So apparently, I was an idiot. And when I discarded the delay, it crashed the stream. But I still have the recording going in one go, so that's something. There's no more delay, so I don't think this is going to be an issue. If there is, it's not going to be a major one. Not worth the effort. I am regretting not taking my Dreadnought, though, but... Victor. Okay, so you have... honestly, a pretty balanced team. The one thing that bugs me the most, actually, is that fossil Pokemon. Yeah, the fossil Pokemon does bug me quite a bit. Otherwise, I think I'm okay with it. As for a lead, what could I have for a lead here? It's not bad. I didn't even look at it actually. That's a pledge team potentially though with this choice specs Incineroar. I'm gonna go Lapras and Clefairy. Yeah, we're gonna sack Clefairy to set up Auraville. While Creamy can come in. There's no Trick Room or anything, so I'm gonna go Togekiss as well for the choice for Scarf. Always my stadium. Never one does anything. Oh, you got the weird music. Yeah, I did. I ended up accidentally stopping the stream to do it, but whatever. It's more inconvenient than anything else, really. So I am going to straight up set up I'm gonna obviously target it down. I have to. And then I am going to follow me. Because the whole point of Clefairy is to die. But I can't see it dying in a single hit. Although this is a Hustle Life Orb thing too, so it might. It might get taken down. Draco's ult is extremely scary for attack power. Especially with the electric terrain set up, so this is gonna be fun. So I can mute my microphone. Yeah. Cracked on my fingers, I don't think anyone wanted to hear that. So we're just gonna try to get rid of that Clefairy as fast as possible, which might end up being more annoying than it's worth, really? I think I should survive? Yeah, barely. That's fine. They use follow me, so I can do another follow me at least for one more turn. Yeah, life orb. So it's a life orb hustle, Dracozolt. We're gonna set up Auraville here, just past the half point, which is good. See, what I'm tempted to do, 140, 120. So they're gonna attack. I'm gonna go for no. I gotta play it safe. We gotta set up rain, and we gotta do another follow me. So that's fine. The whole point of it is to get rid of the Clefairy. I wasn't targeting down your damn thing. It's 140 base, and I get now stab boost. Last thing I want to do is use gravity in this match with that thing out there, because if it does no longer become Dynamaxed, it will have the plus accuracy so they can hit normally. So I either want to go for a blind sing or just abuse follow me. Breaker, that's fine. So I am going to... We are going to go for the attack and the Dracozolt, and we're going to go into a follow me. So no matter what, even if it's a rock slide, it's not going to be that bad. But like, let's say if rock slide misses, it'll be a lot of fun on my end. Nope, it's going for a single attack, so that's going to take out Clefairy. With the Auraville, I should be able to survive despite electric training being up. It only powers up by 30% in this game, not 50. Yep, just barely. But the main thing is we get rid of that stupid Dracozolt. Which we did not do. Damn it. I should have went after the X-Control hand. I mean, I might as well? Question mark? So, it's Hustle and Life Orb. I know it can't outspeed the Choice Scarf. So, three Pokemon left. If I were to protect Lapras, I can keep Lapras for one more turn. And then go for... Well, damn. What? Okay. Yeah, Dazzling Gleam's going to kill off the Dracozolt, so we're just going to try and hope that we can get rid of Excadrill as well. Because this is going to get rid of Dracozolt. No way in the world that survives. Yeah, you went after the wrong one then. As long as this hits, I win. Yep. I like it a lot. Definitely a bit on the wonky side, and the match isn't over by a long shot right now. But what I can do is potentially protect the Lapras, and then go for there. But it's a mixture of that the Mamo team I was using in the last tournament. Really, buddy? Really? Shame on you, man. Yep. Do I get a win for that, or does that affect my side? Like, I actually don't know how rage quitting works, obviously, because I don't pay attention to it. What was his final Pokemon? I'm trying to think. What could it have been? My guess is Incineroar? If he had it, or Primarina? Well, what, I was at like 15-something or another, right? So... Well, whatever, like, I hope I get the win as well, but at the same time, it's like, video game, you're gonna lose more than you're gonna win, unless you somehow have, like, the most perfect team that can counter everything. Isn't that fun? Whatever. Number of battles 4, so that is my fourth battle. And I went up by 0.1? The thing is, fun fact, Pokemon is actually preventing people from doing that as of this tournament, and his account might be flagged and preventing him from participating in online things in general. So you really don't want to be rage quitting and stuff like that anymore. They literally put out that statement, I think, yesterday? Yesterday or the day before? One or two. So, hey, down. One below default. Ooh. I love this idea of this team. So you got Decorate sent to Scorch, you got the thing, you got the Dracovish, you had the Psychic Terrain. I like this a lot. This is really cool. As for what the hell I should do, his team's relatively slow, minus that stupid Dracovish thing. So, honestly, I might just do the same lead as before. Is Lapras and Clefairy. Take Togekiss in the back, and whoever survives, I can buff up with Elcremie, or just even use Elcremie. I'm banking on basically Hitmontop being completely useless for this battle, because obviously the Psychic Terrain will prevent the Bullet Punch, Fake Out, and Sucker Punch. So, although, Gengar, like, Gengar does, no, not a Sludge Wave. Gengar's gonna be probably underutilized on my team, mainly because, ooh, hey, good background. I like your background, K-Town. That's great. Don't rage quit on me. Yeah, so this is probably going to be a decorate. So the NDD cannot use Follow Me. That is the NDD female only move, I believe. So I don't really care for that. So I am actually going to just straight up go for the defense, hit the El Creamy, and I'm going to use Gravity. Because if it wants to try to use Trick Room, which the male can, I am going to be faster and I can start using Sing. Yeah, no, I have mine. If I were to go back and review all the versions I've had of my pass, my guy is standing in daylight, going into nighttime, holding his breath, freezing to death, and now he's trying to jump out of his card. I've been making a small story with it as it's been going. Doesn't matter, we still want to set up, although I would like to hit the NDD more than the other one now, but truthfully I'm still going to do quite a bit of damage, and I'm still going to be doing the gravity stuff. Okay, the NDD has not attacked yet, so I don't know what's happening. But we do have Auroville set up with the Evil Light Clefairy, so we can start learning a lot of attacks too. It was Embor. Yes! I called it! This is gonna be a lot of fun all of a sudden. So, Sandiscorch may be slow, Sandiscorch can die, and we're gonna start abusing Sing on EDD. You need to remember which one is the one that used Trick Room. If you see an NDD male, it's a Trick Room team most likely. So even if this guy were to hit me, I have already set up Auroville, and I have Friend Guard. So there's a very small amount of chance that this thing can actually take out Lapras. And then all I'm going to do is be going to be spamming Sing like hell. Incoming second rage quit, right? Please don't rage quit, man. Yeah, here's Max Overgrowth gonna hit Lapras. It's gonna deal like quarter, maybe? Ish. So this should potentially take out Sentascorch. Because even if it has a Focus Sash, it's obviously been removed because of the initial hit with Ice Resonance. So, nope, not quite yet. That's fine. The thing is, Clefairy was slower, so then I can actually now focus on NDD for at least a turn. So yeah, even with the grassy terrain, even with the buff of 30%, it's not going to be able to get through that. So I'm actually just going to straight up... I'm predicting he's going to be going for... a max guard because he's afraid of Sing. So I'm going to use Helping Hand and powering up the Rain, Hydro Pump, Max Geyser into the NDD slot and hopefully taking it out. Yeah, gravity's always fun. Oh, whatever's coming in is going to get absolutely wrecked, I'll say that. There's the max guard. I called that. There goes the copper shot. I'm so sorry, man. This is when like your team does like the best it possibly can. The initial team I was banking this on actually didn't incorporate Sing or Gravity. It had actually a semi-offensive Clefairy, and I didn't really like that. Because I'm like, if I can get Gravity off, it's like with the Aura Veil, I can spam Sing all I want. And it's really good at Trick Room teams because mine is, even though it's bold, it's still a very slow Pokemon. So we are going to now Hydro Pump against the Alcremie, and we're going to Sing against the Sentascorch, which just used Max Guard. So even if you were to try to do anything with it, it's now disabled for the final turn. Yeah, so here's a decorate onto the sleeping Pokemon. It's not going to really be able to do much. And as long as I hit Hydro Pump, I think Alcremie's dead as well. Nope. Wow, okay, that's quite bulky. I'm very good at predicting. But when I have a team that works, I'm happy with that. So, hey, Jim. So now, if I were to switch out an Alcremie myself, how many turns would gravity or left? This is my last room, trick room, or trick room term and gravity turn. So I want to, Hydro Pump the Centiskorch because it is decorated, and I want to sing against the Alcremie. So it can't do anything, switch in and try to get the last decorate on. Okay, here comes that, that's fine. Here comes the reset of the terrain as well, so I don't have to even worry about the grass damage being anything a factor anymore. Oh wow. Neat. That's with plus two as well. That's his Aurora Veil being really, really useful all of a sudden. Plus the Friend Guard as well, actually. The Friend Guard probably was the factor in that, too. So my guess is I'm actually going to check it. I'm actually going to use Gravity just to make sure. I'm pretty sure Alcremie is going to be trying to use Dazzling Gleam. And if it's going to be using Dazzling Gleam, I'm going to switch out Lapras. Hey man, you can't come over normally anymore, that's the thing. Let's see, is it going to use Dazzling Gleam? So we are going to switch out into my own Togekiss here, and we are going to sing into Alcremie. That crit mattered, that's for sure. This shy. That's unfortunate. So, I am going to I'm going to air slash into Indeedee, and I'm going to sing in the Indeedee as well, because I have a choice. Yeah, there you go. Cool. Good game. Thanks for holding up the entire time, man. Oh, I can set you up, Jim. Just contact me later. I can help you set up OBS and other things. So now, okay. So just to reflect on that match. Clefairy did tons of work, obviously. And I don't think I actually lost a Pokemon there. I think I actually did 4-0 when the battle was canceled. It wasn't guaranteed by the end of it. It was very likely. But if... I don't know if the Alcremie had Dazzling Gleam. Because if it did, then obviously I'd have issues with keeping Lapras alive if I sent it back out. If not, I could do the one last follow me and stuff like that and go for Freeze Dry. But otherwise, it was a really good match. I liked it. I'm just going to do like 15 or something, and I'm going to do some more tomorrow kind of thing. That is a fun match. Oh yeah, no, if you're Fearing Sleep, you're gonna naturally go for a Max Guard first. And I switch Slow Team. This is actually where Alcremie and Hitmontop are gonna be really, really good as a lead. It's either gonna be I decorate the Hitmontop to outspeed the slow Pokemon if it's, let's say, Dusclops and Ferrothorn or something like that. Then, or I can do... Oh, you know what? No, we'll do it that way. And then the Milotic's annoying, but... Honestly, Lapras is just really, really, really fun with Freeze Dry. Freeze Dry also obviously affects the top three of his Pokemon. Honestly, Heat Wave gets rid of most of it, and I can also do Spam Flinches as well. The problem with Gengar, I'll show this off really quickly, is I put Sludge Wave on. I should have paired it with Hypnosis into Shadow Ball, because it can reverse Trick Room and stuff like that as well, but the thing is with it is if it had Hypnosis, it could pair with Clefairy really, really well as well. So, you know, what can I do? Yeah, I'm just gonna go Togekiss. Clefairy is really good there. I don't really need the redirection though. Yeah! I also have the full Pokedex as well too. Also, welcome back to my stadium! They're always in my stadium because everyone always has weird backgrounds that don't involve stadiums. This is fine. So Clear Body is really good tell as well. What I will do here is I actually will just straight up Dynamax, go into the G-Max finale, and I will go into a Fake Out. But I want to make sure I stop the redirection before there's a chance for that. And I want to try to take out as fast as possible the Dragapult, which is the one Dynamaxing right now, potentially. So the whole point is obviously the redirection, protect the Dragapult, keep it brittle. Thing is, it can't hit me with a Dragon attack. I do get Fake Out before anything else, and it does have Intimidate against, for whatever reason, Togekiss, if that really matters. Probably not, unless you're running a physical one. Thumbs up if you are. But overall, it's not going to matter as much. No, Fake Out has plus one on it. Helping Hand, though, is different. So he called the Fake Out then. Which is fine. I don't think he... Yeah, he's... Fake Out? Yeah, I think I win this one, buddy. But I'm not going after the defense stat. Wow. So here's the thing. I want to max guard and protect, and then I want to switch out to Togekiss. Because if he's going to try to take down my Alcremie, because he is still faster, I don't have to worry too much about that. No, I don't want to use Sucker Punch, because if he uses Follow Me, it does redirect the Sucker Punch. And there's no way in the world that Hitmontop would be able to take down that much. But here's the block. Now, we're going to use G-Max Finale purposely on the Togekiss, and we have the Choice Scarf Dazzling Gleam to take out this Pokemon. So he's going to use Follow Me. That's fine. We want to actually hit the Togekiss. So now we have the Dazzling Gleam, which should take out the Dragapult. Don't have to worry about that anymore. And then we get our HP back with the G-Max finale with the plus two against Togekiss to possibly take that out. There we go. No, my specialty is calling the matches. If I have a team that works, it's a different story, me. People need to realize that. If I have a good team, I can really sweep people. If nothing else, this is the one match I want to highlight after all this. So now we have... That's fine. We don't mind this, because not only am I plus two, I also have Mystical Fire, so I can absolutely nuke this Ferrothorn. And I'm actually going to switch out into Hitmontop here, so I can get the Intimidate and a Fake Out Pressure once Trick Room does go off after this. If somehow I don't take down the Ferrothorn. But here's a Protect, that's fine, we don't mind that. We're gonna use Mystical Fire, that's also fine. So, the thing to do in this situation would be, wow, I am screwed. But the thing is, now that I got the Intimidate off, I don't have to worry too much about it. Plus, I still have Togekiss to do Heat Wave. So that itself is a protection, and I still also have Perish Song as a thing. And if he wants to play the long game, I can play the long game and I can win. So if Hitmontop were to get hit here, I am going to be switching out and using Perish Song. I predict an ally switch, I will actually be targeting down both... Yeah, I will target down... predicting an ally switch. Oh wow! No ally switch. Nightshade. Huh. Really? No ally switch on that? Anyway, I'm going to be switching out to Lapras. And keep Alcremia alive for now. So we'll switch out. And then we will... We will Sucker Punch? Yeah, we will Sucker Punch the Dusclops slot. That's a good amount of damage for that. Now this is why I really wanted to see, because he wants to play the long game. And I'm okay with playing the long game. Two turns of Trick Room, so it's not worth me trying to stall it out. What I can do, again, is still Sucker Punch the Dusclops slot. And constantly punish him for trying to do Nightshades. Now here's the switch. And hopefully, if he's doubling up into Hitmontop, I can actually go into Alcremie here, possibly sack Alcremie, and then once Trick Room does expire after the turn is done, I can do Choice Scarf Heat Wave. Yeah, he's playing the long game. That's not gonna pan out. I got too many Pokemon. So there's my end game win. I have all four Pokemon, and he has three turns to kill me. So we are going to now Protect. That's our winning condition. And just one last time, we are going to switch out into Hitmontop. Have the fake out pressure. I'm not going to be surprised if he cancels the match. No. Okay, so he's staying in. So we're going to again lower the attack so grass attacks and gyro ball cannot hurt Lapras. If he goes for body press when he's raising up his defense and stuff like that, which I think he might do. Oh, ally switch and fake out. Of course it will work. Okay, here's body press using the defense stat, taking out Hitmontop. Oh, and a critical hit too. Oh dear. So now the Twisted Dimensions return to normal. We can now send out Togekiss. Yeah, we're going to send out Togekiss. And we're going to switch out Lapras, because Lapras actually is the only one that has Protect. So we're going to go for the Choice Scarf. Switch out Elcrini, and we're going to go for the Choice Scarf Heat Wave, now at a Trick Room. And then the last turn will be me using Protect to no matter what win. That is my win condition. Good job, Elcrini. You're going to take a hit. They both missed. That's great. Yeah, it's nothing. You can use Pain Split. That's funny. We are going to then Mystical... No, we're just going to Dazzling Gleam and... Again, Heat Wave. It's funny how both missed. I didn't think... There you go. Good game. Thanks for holding out, not rage quitting. You did a really good job, player. I don't know what your name is, but, you know, I like you. I like the team a lot. I was versing there, too. So, to reflect on that match, Lapras, obviously a Parasong is great. A lot of people will run Thunder or Thunderbolt on it just to encourage the rain, then instant attacks after. Normally runs a weakness policy. Body press is really, really threatening. But the thing is, if you're going to play the long game against me, you better make sure you know what you're doing. Because, like, the whole reason I have Parasong on that is because I died in one of the previous matches I was playing online. Not with this team, but with another team. I was using a weakness policy Lapras. And, my god, that thing just cannot deal with body press. And, like, it can't deal with the Ferrothorn. It can't do whatever. All it can do is protect. Well, if all it can do is protect, well, you might as well go for the Parasong. Alternate things, and obviously Hitmontop and stuff like that was a really good choice for alternating the intimidates and fake outs. So we're gonna continue battling. I might only do 10 today because I'm getting tired. I am very physically tired right now, and my university is taking up a lot of my free time. Today is my day off, but I have to go back and do a lot of chemistry tomorrow. 1465. So we have an Appleton, a Goodra. Goodra is an annoying one. I don't like seeing that, but I don't mind seeing it. Mimikyu, it's not going to be a Trick Room variant. It's probably going to be a Sword Dance variant. Dragapult, we saw what that did last time. If it wants to try to verse me, by all means. And then we have the Lapras. And if they're going to try to do this again, I am going to be fine. I am going to do Lapras and Clefairy, Elcrini, and I can't... Honestly, I don't mind Togekiss, because once again, Togekiss with Fairy takes out basically the top three dragons. Props for using three dragons, use what you want. And worst comes to worst, and it boils down to it, is I can potentially spam Air Slash Serene Grace. It's not the nicest way of winning, but you can technically win that way. So I like having that in the back as well. And Elcrini can decorate the Lapras after the Clefairy goes down. And also has a weakness policy as well, that they try to hit it, and it survives. All of a sudden, whoops. But I don't think there's really much need for Fake Out with two ghosts. Like, Fake Out might only be good for the first two or three turns, and if I have Hitmontop out there, other than just basically using Sucker Punch, I can't do too much towards those two ghosts. So Hitmontop with fighting and that, all I can really do is Bullet Punch after that, or bank on when they're going to be hitting me. So we're going for Lapras and Appleton. Appleton probably will be G-Max. If it isn't, I'd be surprised, but I am going to try and nuke it. And we are going to use Gravity. I don't think it's actually going to kill me, even if they were to both go up against me. Freeze Dry from Lapras, maybe? But I can see him Dynamaxing Lapras before anything else. Appleton restores the status effects of your partner Pokemon on the field with his grass type move. The other one lowers accuracy or evasion by one stage. Let me quickly look up Appleton and what is actually Appleton? I know I got that one right. Heals the conditions of allies, yeah. And what is Flapple? Flapple, I think, lowers the target's evasiveness by one. So, yeah, I'm faster if he's not Dynamaxing. So yeah, that's the difference between the two of them. Oh, that's not a good sign. That's not a good sign at all. Because if that's Lapras, I'm going to be... Oh, that's not good. Even with the Protect, I'm going to be absolutely nuking the Appleton on the sky here, because it is Grass Dragon. Yeah. And we're setting up Gravity, so we're going to be doing the Sleep Spam, obviously, after. That's fine. Hey, squishy. I really do love G-Max Lapras. I knew when it was going to be coming out, it was going to be like one of my favorite things to use, because I really love bulky teams. Well, I haven't seen a kind of a Psychic Fang counter to it yet when I've been doing online matches. That's going to be an Assault Vest, Assault Vest Gudra, and the Alcremie will be great for dealing that when it comes back in, but for now, I am just going to be, I don't really fear the Gudra, so I'm just going to attack it, and I'm just going to use Sing against the Lapras, because I think it can learn a poison move. Yeah, that's not gonna be much. No paralysis? Yeah, okay. Oh, I love shiny Gudra. That's gonna be, again, not very much, because obviously just the sheer bulk of my build is something really, really threatening. So then, oh, smart! I approve of that. Cool. Okay, if that's the case... Yeah, we're just gonna straight up... G-Max Resonance. And we are going to switch out to Alcremie then. Actually, no, we will follow me. I forgot Electric Train would have stopped that. That's actually really smart. That's intentional by all means. That's really cool. Oh, it's a great thing. So this should be able to take both attacks easily. Yeah. And then that's even with a crit too. But like, I want to make sure, obviously, the Gudra goes down basically at this point. So now we want Alcremie to come out, and we want to spam Decorate onto Lapras, because Gudra is very, very slow. I don't have to worry too much about it. And the worst it can do is just kind of hit me for a little bit of damage. But what we're going to do is we are going to kill off the Gudra first and decorate the Lapras. That's fine. As long as there's no paralysis, I'm fine. There you go. Really? Oh no. I have to check something after. Oh no. Oh no. I never bottle capped the Alcremie. Oh dear. Honestly, Dazzling Gleam still be the best bet, and still spamming Decorate on Togekiss will be the best bet. I think, yeah. Alcremie has like a higher base than Gudra, and mine is modest. Unless it's a choice Scarf Gudra, that might be the case. But I'm pretty sure I did bottle cap all the Pokemon, but I did make them in a huff. Yeah, Blizzard's always going to hit now because of the gravity. But we're going to start spamming the Decorate here. Okay, gravity's worn off, so we don't have to worry about Blizzard hitting 100% of the time right now as well, so that's semi-nice. That might be a Togekrit, though. If that's the case, that's kind of annoying, but... we are going to... we're just gonna go do a double Dazzling Gleam. Because if he uses Follow Me, that's a waste of a turn. But I definitely gotta check the IVs of my team. That's gonna be crits? No. Dazzling Gleams everywhere! Yeah, no. Yeah, that's the winning condition of getting rid of my Togekiss, so... that's a very bulky, or very offensive Lapras. So I'm going to assume is weakness policy. Sorry, the vacuum got turned on downstairs. Okay. Couldn't kill it. I get some HP back, that's fine. Do I get... no. Okay, so we're gonna again go for the Giga Drain. Yeah, you're going for the flinchers, that's fine. I think I lost this one because of... oh, I got the... man, if only I had Draining Kiss instead of... oh, we're gonna use Mystical Fire. Draining Kiss is great because it heals back 75% of your damage, not... woo! Barely surviving. Yeah, there's a lot of weird music in this game. That's why I prefer to have random on and not just the same song. GG! I need to check my IVs. I may not have bottle capped before making this team. And if that's the case, I'm gonna have to take notes on certain things. But I'm pretty sure they always had defenses. We're gonna quit battling for a second. Gonna check out this thing here. Hyper trained. Clefairy again, not supposed to be. That's a telling sign. Whoops. That's fine. That explains why I can't do much damage. Damn it. Whoops. I'm pretty sure it's impossible for me to fix it because they're protected, but let's see. Oh boy. I'm doing great with a decent attacked weakness policy. How creamy. Well now, I'm doing pretty good judging by what the hell my team is. Back to my icy town. Oh boy, it's my bad. Oh well. Honestly, the Alcremie does like the weakness policy. It would be able. That's probably why it didn't kill the Dragapult. Just to check, did I say decent? Because decent means like 1 to 10. What are you? I think you're full. Let's look at the damage calculator and figure this out quickly. Modest. Oh boy, that's really, really bad. Oh well, that's just what I get for rushing things. I was in a big huff when I was trying to make things. 178. Oh wait, no, 100. Wait, no, that's not 252. Oh, I have the splits written down here. So. 160 it has, not 252. Yeah. Creamy, right? Oh, creamy. Modest. Best. Oh. Hey, chat. Do you want to guess how much IVs it actually has? Okay, we're doing a support route on this one then. My bad. That probably guarantees I'll just do today's only. Because I don't think I'll be able to go up. Oh damn. Oh damn. Welp. Let's go up to these 10 matches. We'll do that. For those who are wondering, it has one. A single IV in special attack. So, yeah. Oh, it frees up my weekend. Because... Because, yeah, looking at the damage calculator, if I have a modest Alcremie that has 292 special attack with 160 special investment, it means I have a whopping 1. So it's going to be mostly going to be used for decorate right now. Or if I can know if I can get like a 4 times effective hit, like it's Hydreigon or something like that. Oh man, I knew I forgot to do something before I registered this team. I knew I should have checked that. Oh well, it's all for fun. There's no CP riding on this battle. There's 3 more battles, and then either I'll go up to 15, I don't know yet. Like, I've been recording for an hour and a half, technically, so I'm kind of
That's really dumb. That's really, really dumb.
1576, cool. So we got the solar power, sunny day, prankster support. We got the trick room, not trick room, sorry. We got the sandstorm excadrill. And we got the tailwinds, Dracovish, and then we have Dragapult. So this person's absolutely zero against Trick Room. And even though Gengar only has decent, or sorry, no good attack and decent defense, it is a Trick Room setter. But I can get that one off. Yeah. So we can possibly go for... Actually, no, what we will do... We'll bring Gengar in the back, but we'll bring up Gengar after we try to set up Lapras. And then... I'm pretty sure the Togekiss is fine. I'm pretty sure that one's fine. And Togekiss probably would be the better bet. Dazzling Gleam would be effective against a couple of them, but honestly, having a Choice Scarf versus Excadrill would be a lot better too. But we'll go with that. Oh man. That was really dumb of me. I knew it. So yeah, we're gonna go Dragapult and Charizard. Dragapult's gonna Dynamax, most likely. And we're gonna go for the Solar Beam. Even... He would have to have Solar Power Life Orb, I think, to take out Lapras with that. So what we will do is we will target down the Charizard, and we will... I knew I should have brought Oprah to the start. Weakness Policy would have been really good too. I mean, if he fakes out Charizard... No, we gotta do this. We gotta set it up, and we gotta risk doing the fake out versus the Charizard. If that's the case, then we can possibly get the best case scenario going. So if this is the Dragapult, Repeat Ball, probably not. It's probably gonna be caught. That's gonna be a G-Max Charizard caught in an event. Yeah. So we're gonna possibly be able to take out the... Possibly able to take out the Dragapult, but we're going to take a lot of hit from the two Pokemon. Unless they somehow target down, they'd be dumb to do, but they'd be, if they target down Hitmontop, I don't think that's going to go. Oh boy. Take that, you. Take my fist in your general direction. Dragon darts? Okay, that's fine. That means I can actually save Hitmontop for coming back in, actually. What we will do is we will send out Gengar. Thank you, Gengar, for your service. it's gonna die from the wildfire, though, so it's not really the best. But I probably can take out the Dragapult if it's not Focus Sashed. I think it is, though. Yeah, no, that's fine. Yeah, that takes off like 1/6 of your HP. No, that's colossal. What does this do? Yeah, it's still a good chunk. I mean, I would really, really, really like this to send in. Yeah, we're gonna send in again. Hitmontop. Even though it is most likely a special-based Charizard, there's no reason to use a physical one this game. But we do have the Bullet Punch. We are also going to Max Geyser the Charizard slot, and we are going to Bullet Punch the Dragapult. So it can't use those Dragon Darts again. And by doing this, we can kind of shift things around a little bit. That's fine, I don't mind that. Actually, I was really tempted to do close combat, but that's kind of funny. Well, by doing this, he's going to kind of guarantee me, maybe a weakness policy Trinitar, though. That's the problem. If you see a Trinitar, assume weakness policy. Yeah, here's the speed boost. So we're going to set up the rain, so we're going to get rid of the special defense boost, though. Oh, just shy. Well, that guarantees me I'm going to be using Dazzling Gleam now. So we will use his Rock Slide's kind of dumb. If I Max Guard, yeah, I'm just gonna go for the Max Geyser on Trinitar, and I'm gonna go for the Dazzling Gleam on both. I know I'm not gonna be able to kill the Charizard, but the Charizard's not really the main threat. Obviously, the weakness policy tiny little guy is. Oh, I cut myself on my finger. I mean, that's fine. You're still gonna get nuked out of the water there. He really wants to support that, Wait, Max Knuckle? Is that actually a physical variant Charizard then? I honestly would have went for the double speed. I mean, if I were to protect and he lures into that and I can do Dazzling Gleam, I can take out the Charizard and possibly a Trinitar and a hit. And keep Lapras safe if he tries to go for like a Stone Edge or something. Yeah, there you go. So that plus one speed, I still able to outspeed the Trinitar, which is nice. Not safe at all. Like, I'm probably gonna lose this, but I'm definitely gonna try to put up a fight and not rage quit like that second match guy. Excadrill. Not happy to see that. And Dragapult. Honestly, really happy to see that because I got the Dazzling Gleam, so we kinda are okay because. If we hit the Hydro Pump, we should be fine. And then Dazzling Gleam, I'm pretty sure we outspeed both of them. Because if he has a Trinitar on his team, it's most likely going to be a Sandrush one. And it didn't pop up with Mold Breaker. So that means I'm at least going to be able to break the Focus Sash, which was already on Dragapult. So, and I still have Aura Veil up, so theoretically I might win, as long as I hit this Hydro Pump. I was gonna say, I'm pretty sure I still should have survived that, unless it's a Life Orb. Life Orb? Yeah, you got the Life Orb on you. We win! Good game, person! Good job, Daniel. I like that match a lot. So, let's reflect on that match for a second. What worked and what didn't work? Locking into the Dazzling Gleam because the rain's out means I could have possibly... I didn't know if I did outspeed, but I am timid, I believe. Yeah, timid and max speed, Choice Scarf, Togekiss. It's a lot of fun. Other than that, I'm pretty sure I would have lost if I brought any other Pokemon. Like, that was literally the clutch Pokemon the entire match. Gengar being sent in to die didn't really accomplish anything because it still died from the wildfire, but we did finally get to use Gengar in one match. Creamy would have died. That was horrible there. Hitmontop was really good, just because that little extra threat of Fake Out made him have to focus down Hitmontop. But at the same time, the other Pokemon was potentially, you know, Dragapult, so I couldn't do much. The Aura Veil was extremely crucial in that match. If it wasn't for that, I probably easily would have died, from damage alone. So, you got two more matches at least. But good job, Daniel. That was a really good match. I pulled that one out of my butt, I'll say that one right now, but that's why you don't give up to the last turn, because you can always turn things around. I'm not gonna try to pronounce that. Okay, we got screens. We have Sirfetch'd. I like that. So, what can we do here? That's gonna be a Trick Room variant team. Rillaboom has Fake Out. He's not gonna use Psychic Terrain and Rillaboom in the same team, but he's gonna see my Lapras there and he's gonna choose to lead with that. So if that's the case, we are going to go all creamy and hit one top. No. We're going to do all creamy and Lapras. And we're going to go for the decorate. And then we're going to send out Togekiss. Because Sirfetch'd, Rillaboom, and Duraludon. And I think our final one will have to be Clefairy. Yeah. We're gonna go for kind of the base. We're gonna go for the base kind of. I like your card. Aura Veil setup, I really want to do. And presume he doesn't have a Fake Out user. If he doesn't have a Fake Out user, we're golden. Fake Out can be used on Grimmsnarl, so I don't know. But the thing is, what we can do here is if he's going to try to do anything, we're going to G-Max Lapras, and we're still going to set up Aura Veil because he can't stop that. He can set up screens, and I can fight through screens if he wants to play that game. But the thing is, I just want to make sure. Oh, you're just slower. Oh, whatever. We're still going to set up screens and we're still going to target down the Duraludon. Duraludon is going to be the one that's going to be Dynamaxing. Unless it's a G-Max of all things. If it's going to be a G-Max Grimmsnarl. But if it does that, then that's really dumb. Yeah. I'm still looking for a shiny stalwart one of them. 9-3. Yeah, I probably want to go to 10 matches. No matter what, we're going to set up Aura Veil. We're probably going to... Yep, there's a light screen. I knew that was coming. I don't mind that. That's going into El Creamy. Which is just going to die. My old one used to have a Focus Sash on, so that would have been fine. Focus Sash decorates really funny when people do stuff like that. But I knew that was going to come out. But the thing is, the main thing I want is this setup and... what's up? The Joyludon taking a little bit of damage, but not as much as I'd want. But I got Aura Veil set up, and that's my main goal. Because there's the other way of playing this. And we are going to... First of all, we're going to go for a Blind Sing into Joyludon. And then we are going to... Probably this Max Geyser. Go for the damage against the Grimmsnarl. Let's see if we actually hit this thing. If we do, then that's something. That's fine. Good move. And we get it! So now we're gonna Helping Hand. And we're going to G-Max Geyser against the Grimmsnarl. No one likes a Blind Sing, for the record. I don't take credit for that, but that's a possible winning condition, and you shoot for it. I can guarantee the other guy's mad on the other side of the screen right now, though. So because of the Helping Hand and the rain, we should be able to get rid of the rest of the damage onto the Grimmsnarl. There we go. So now we don't have to worry about potential T-waves coming out as well, and once the light screen goes off, we're fine. They both are going down. He does have Meteor Assaults with the Sirfetch'd. I'm not overly concerned about it, but I will go for a Sing into the slot. Actually, no, I will actually go Helping Hand. And what's my last Pokemon? Togekiss. Togekiss can come in with Dazzling Gleam. So I am going to... Yeah, we're going to Helping Hand into Freeze Dry. And I don't think he can take down Lapras with the Friend Guard on the field. That's fine. That's why we did Helping Hand. Also, we're going to Sing. Yeah. No, Clefairy has done its job. Duraludon's going to wake up this turn most likely, so we're going to lure out an attack. And we are going to, once again, go for Sirfetch. How we wanted to initially. But here comes the Steel Attack, or Lightning Bolt, or something. Flash Cannon, there you go. Possibly actually already targeting down the Clefairy, that might be what he wanted. Otherwise it'd be neutral damage if he didn't have a Lightning move. Here comes the Hydro Pump into the Sirfetch'd. It's about right. So he's getting the minus special defense drop. I'm pretty sure people would not use him without a stick, but it's possible. Someone might do that. But here comes my choice scarf, Dazzling Gleam versus a dragon and a thing. So we are going to Dazzling Gleam, and we're going to protect the Lapras. No, we're gonna... No, we're gonna freeze dry the Duraludon. We're just gonna go straight up offensive. Because it's not gonna matter either way. Why is that? Okay. Well, he still has minus one special defense though, so... Yeah. That's fine. I'm pretty sure whatever Swordfish has, unless it has Iron Head, can't really... Oh! Poison Dab! Neat. Critical? Hey! He has a stick! Let's go. Ah, GG. That was a good match. That was a really good match. I like that. Ah, he's 20 above me. That's why he... Dumb joke. Honestly, that's probably the best I could have done with my team. Duraludon does scare the bejesus out of me, mainly because I don't really have a way to deal with steel Pokemon that are resistant to fire. T-Block not playing Pokemon. So this one might be my last one. I don't know. I'm going on for like 2 hours. I'm kind of getting tired and my calls are getting a little bit sloppier. That and knowing my team isn't really Ivy red is kind of intimidating. But we'll see how that goes. Challenger. So we have, honestly, a pretty decent team to go up against. I don't mind Lapras Hitmontop as to start. Definitely gonna go Togekiss. And I definitely want Okremi. The thing is, if Okremi had its proper speed, it would outspeed Lapras, so you can go decorate and attack. That's great. It's two less than Lapras' speed right now. So unless it's Trick Room, I can't do that. Honestly, between Freeze Dry destroying the Gastrodon, which honestly just might be the first turn if they try to lure it. Just straight up go for like close combat against Tyranitar if it's out. Or if it's not, then you know. Nothing is resistant to fake out here. So that's why Hitmontop is going to be starting. Flygon. Eh. Once this tournament is done, if I withdraw after today because I don't want to battle with a team that isn't Ivy bred properly. I'll fix them up. I will post my team on Twitter with the rental thing properly, not just the one I made before that had all the problems. This one. Well, I really, really should have put Hypnosis on Gengar. Hey, Zed. How you doing? Yeah, okay. So what we're going to be doing here is freeze dry, close combat. We're just going to get rid of the Gastrodon. Or sorry, fake out into... No. We're going to go close combat because if it Dynamaxes, then that's a problem. If Gastrodon Dynamaxes, the freeze dry is just going to wreck it. I don't have to worry about the plus one speed. I'm having fun. I'm doing great. So we're going to do that, and we're going to bank on Tyranitar Dynamaxing, but we're still going to hit it for as hard as we can. But I am still max speed, and even if it has weakness policy, it's going to be at plus one. Lapras avoid the attack? Well, that's Gastrodon dead. Is that choice carved? Hard to see. Honestly, I just really, really like the idea of Alcremie coming out. Is it Life Orb? I didn't see that. Not paying attention, clearly. That's fine. Okay, so we're gonna be doing... Ooh, shiny, shiny. Oh, you're right, yeah, it has Life Orb damage on it. So we're gonna go G-Max Resonance into the Bravery, and we are going to decorate our Lapras for a turn after because I messed up my IVs. It wouldn't be a problem if it was timid, you know that? Hey, Jimmy's playing. Yeah, so that's gonna be the Bravery. Even if it's Defiant, I'm not really too concerned about it. Oh, that's at minus one. Even if Life Orb, I really don't care. I'm not taking away the Sandstorm. So, if Bravery survives the Focus Sash, it's gonna die. So, I really don't fear that. And with the Dynamax out, I really don't fear a close combat from both of them. And I doubt that the Trinitar is faster than Bravery. We're going into Alcremie. Okay. Max Rockfall into Lapras isn't going to kill me at minus one. It goes to Bravery. Set that up. With the Aura Veil doing 50% damage, even after the Sandstorm damage, I should still be fine. Honestly, I should just cycle, I should max guard and then just cycle in, Ooh. Chinese. No, I should definitely get rid of that. But what I will do is cycle in Hitmontop again so I don't die to, Trinitar's attack. I highly doubt he's going to be using Earthquake with Flygon. Probably going to be something just to chip damage and get rid of fairy Pokemon. But it's better just to do the double Intimidate against two Intimidators, or attackers. It's a weakness policy. Yeah, it's not weakness policy. That was, Oh, come on, just shy. Whatever. I'm okay with that. I got, Oh. I'm guessing the back here. I honestly thought that was a Earthquake weakness policy combo there. So we're going to Dazzling Gleam, and we are going to Close Combat? Yeah. I didn't realize he only has two Pokemon left. That's the better choice. It's choice. Because that's a choice Scarfed Flygon. And if it's that, it can't kill me now. Oh, GG. But I just forget it's not flying. It has levitate. So close combat's neutral damage. Mm, good job. Oof. But do I want to keep going? Like, are people still interested in me doing my last five matches for the day kind of thing? Or like... Because like, I'm... messed up the IVs and I don't feel like I can, sure, I'll do that then. Let me just go use the bathroom quickly, then I'll do that. There you go. Yeah, because... like, not happy with the whole Alcremie and stuff like that being too slow, or not having... or literally only having one IV in special attack. But... you know, the thing. Oh, I think Ruby's coming up here. Let me open the door for him. We have a screen setting Alcremie, Gastrodon, Gyarados. It's the alleged Shawnee, yeah. Oh, it's a good Obi. Hey, the adoption date for Obis. The 1 year anniversary when we adopted him. He's had a good day. Yeah, I have a bath because of it, because damn, he just walked through like every mud puddle. He's all soft and smells like pomegranate. Honestly, I like Lapras. Can't really do too much to me, even otherwise. Like, probably Hitmontop, Clefairy. Go up that route. And then... thank you, Obi. Rolling on the ground right now. He's being cute. Probably Alcremie? No. Togekiss probably can clean up. Thank you, Obi. Yeah, Togekiss can probably clean up. Sorry, you're gonna hear the jingles and stuff. Oh, you're leaving me? Okay, go see Sarah. Bye-bye.
That's it? That's all I get? What a jerk.
He doesn't like it when I'm upstairs and Sarah's downstairs. But he gets upset. So he comes up here when I went to the bathroom, opened the door, he heard me come in the room. Went to check up on me. Then just left again. Hell yeah, we got the team Yomik. Oh hey, we're in a different Coliseum. Someone actually has a different background. They chose theirs. Okay, so we got... it's gonna be a Moxie. Okay, so what we can do here... okay, so we can fake out and freeze dry. Because what the plan is with this is we're going to hit the Grimmsnarl, prevent him from using T-Wave or some other shenanigans like that, or setting up screens. And Freeze Dry is effective against water Pokemon, so I don't want to Dynamax just yet, but if Gyarados does Dynamax, I can wipe it out. And since it does have... since it does have an Intimidate on it, I don't really fear it right now. And if it does end up hitting Hitmontop, I can cycle out the Clefairy and redirect and then set up Aura Veil. So. Yeah, so there goes Gyarados. Here comes Tyranitar. I don't mind that as well. Mainly because I can just go for the close combat now. And essentially, I'm just getting some free damage off. And then next turn, I will go for the Resonance move versus Grimmsnarl. And then close combat against Tyranitar. And if they happen to hit Tyranitar, or hit my top beforehand, I don't have to worry too much about that. But we'll hopefully be able to take down the Tyranitar. If it Dynamaxes, it Dynamaxes. If it doesn't, he's keeping it against a fighting Pokemon. But I can redirect and I can do the G-Max water, or not G-Max water move, sorry, the Dynamax water move. Set up rain, take away special defense. You know, there's a lot of stuff I can do. Oh, Obi's attacking his peacock down there. That's what his toy was that he got for today. Massive, it's funny. Like a third of the weight of him as well, it's a big toy. Okay, they are not Dynamaxing. So, what this tells me is either he's spamming a screen to try to protect the Tyranitar, or he's going to be sacking both Pokemon because I either am going to outspeed him if he's not careful, or this is going to be very problematic. Also, a lot of people expect Weakness Policy Lapras. That's fine. I don't mind that. I'm not targeting down... So what are you doing? You're doing a light screen. That's fine. I'm okay with that. So the nice thing is about this is I get obviously my screen set up. Just trying to think of the actual potentials here. Because now I can... Yeah, I can G-Max and take that away and still go for the close combat. Because now with this, the defensive support and Clefairy in the back, I don't really have to worry about Tyranitar right now. Here comes Gyarados. A Rank Master. I love the ribbon titles. That's fine. That's a lot of damage against a Gyarados. Holy jeez. Okay. Clefairy gets Evil Light, so it can double or times its both defenses both by 1.5. Versus Clefable, which just has more HP, really. So this is good, because we get a cycle out... Although... No, it's better to send out Togekiss right now. Because we got the Choice Scarf, Dazzling Gleam. And we can take out the Grimmsnarl, and we can target down with the Ice move, the Gyarados. And then once the Tyranitar comes in, it's still weak to the Dazzling Gleam. So, we're gonna go with that. Also, Frengard, yes. Frengard is a really good ability. It got released when Home came out. It lowers the damage your allies take by 33% as well, and with the Aura Veil, it makes Lapras extremely hard to get rid of. So this is going to be the Gyarados Dynamaxing. It's not really much of a threat right now. So NK Soul in chat is one of the Pokemon groups around, or one of the people in the Pokemon group here. Oh, he's just setting up both. He does not want to have. That's. Oh, there goes the Grimmsnarl. That's fine. That's not gonna kill. Again, we're gonna go for some damage onto the Gyarados. Ooh, not much at all there. Wonder if it's assault vested with the light screen. Maybe it is. Maybe it is. Either way, he's gonna send out Tyranitar. Tyranitar is gonna set up the Sandstorm. And then I'm gonna lose my Dynamax, but I'm gonna be able to survive the Gyarados and use use a Dazzling Gleam beforehand and still send out Tyranitar for after. So I can have the fake out pressure onto the Tyranitar slot and just kind of focus down the Gyarados. We're just gonna freeze dry Gyarados and we are going to against Dazzling Gleam. Well, we can't do anything else. We're Choice Scarfed. We're going to Dazzling Gleam into the Tyranitar slot there. That weakness policy? Yep. I don't really fear it too much right now. Max Overgrowth. Okay, that's a little more annoying, so it's gonna do a little bit more damage I'd like. I'm pretty sure I still have Speed Gyarados, or the Tyranitar though. I'm not too sure. How much speed investment do I have? No, oh, I didn't write down. Oh, there you go, there you go. That might win him the game. Oh, I should have just switched out to Hitmontop, taking the attack, and then got the minus one on them. Hindsight's 20/20 sometimes, right? Oh. Yeah, the screens he set up was really good. I think that's his last turn of Dynamax? No, he has one more. So we're gonna fake out Tyranitar, and we're actually gonna sing the Gyarados. Yeah, we're doing this stuff again. Then if we get that, we're gonna try to follow me close combat, follow me close combat, and then Sucker Punch to win. That's the basic strategy here. Oh, he's a thinking. I'm dead now. I have no attack move, so I'll just forfeit. Megas suck. Megas absolutely suck. Dynamax wears off after three turns. You can stall them out. You can use sleep on them. You can hinder them. They're not a win-all. They have different effects on them if they're Dynamax or G-Max. Megas, high Mega Kangaskhan. I hated you for like three straight years. Absolutely hated Megas. Only Mega that they really did that was really cool, but they never did anything with, was Mega Beedrill. That thing was so fun to use, but it was so fragile and so dumb. I can't win. All I'm gonna do is stall them out. Not worth it. Right. I guess they could have used Follow Me. Whatever, doesn't matter. We'll keep doing some matches. We'll go up to 15. But yeah, no, I absolutely hated Megas. Because like the second it Mega Evolved, it stayed Mega Evolved. If you made it so if it switched out, it lost it, I'd be fine with it. But it was just way too annoying. So we have four more battles left. That'll be my day one thing. And then I think I won't do day two or day three because obviously the IVs are really crippling me right now. I really should have checked them before registering the team for the tournament. I know now for next time. Maybe I'll just like unregister for the tournament and do a quick online battle with the team proper after all this is all done. It's like the fact I can't use all creamy the way I want right now. I mean, it's one IV, and it's, Alright, who are we versing now? Red. Not Pokemon Trainer Red, just Red. Alright, we got Colossal, we got Dragapult, which is probably gonna have Surf on it. Colossal, we got the Ice, we got Aura Veil, we got G-Max Lapras, because there's no reason not to use it. And Heat Rotom. So what can we do here? We can do this. Oh, creamy. I don't think they can kill all creamy. No. Well. No, we're actually gonna go a different route here. We're gonna go Hitmontop, that, creamy, and probably just Lapras in the back. You know, Lapras doesn't really have access to its item if it can't G-Max. It's still really, really good. We're gonna go with that. We're gonna try something a little bit different here. So they're going for Aura Veil. That's fine. Just checking some discords here. So I don't think I'm going to actually use Bullet Punch on my own Pokemon. No, I will. I use G-Max Flare. I will hit Ninetales. And I will... we'll just go for Alcree. I love the cake. I really love the cake. I still think somewhere after they revealed it back in the announcement trailer, I absolutely fell in love with this damn thing. So the nice thing about this is when you're doing this with the weakness policy, and you should be faster, but that's beside the point. Yeah, okay. Really? You're not using G-Max Lapras? Okay. Kind of neat. I mean, by all means, if Blizzard's coming out from Lapras, it's gonna have a hard time hitting with the. Like. Neat. That's fine. So we're gonna send out our own I mean... No, we're going to send out Tokiss. The nice thing about G-Max Lapras with the Bullet Punch is you can activate it, and if you're fast enough, you can also kill a Pokemon with the Weakness Policy buff. And then on top of that, get your HP back by using G-Max Finale. It's a lot of fun. Got our chip. So I'm not too afraid of Bragapult by itself. So I'm just going to use a Dazzling Gleam here. It should be faster, and if Lapras tries to go after Tokiss, I don't really care. But I don't want to activate the Weakness Policy potentially on the Lapras there without taking it out, so I'm going to try to double it up, obviously. And robo-voicing a little, that's odd. It might be because my noise gate is a little bit farther away from me. I was just lying back in the chair a bit. Is it a little bit better now, or is it still doing dumb things? Okay, that is the right microphone. I don't know. It's having issues. I don't know. Okay, here's a G-Max Lapras here. So what we're gonna be doing here, really shouldn't. Maybe this is via stream, but it really shouldn't be having an issue. Whatever. We're going to be using. We're going to be targeting down both of them here. We still have another Pokemon in the back, too, with the Alcremie. So, neat. I don't really mind that as much. Freeze Dry will hopefully get rid of this. Half. That's fine. And I have Grassy Terrain up to do the extra damage here. So there goes that Lapras. Critical did not matter. Unless Aura Veil and Light Screen can stack. But no, it was just Aura Veil. That's all it was. So I don't mind. In the same time, one more attack can take out... What's it called? Dragapult there. Colossal. I mean, I can decorate and, actually what I can do is I can use Dazzling Gleam, target down both of them, and I can use Hydro Pump onto Colossal, potentially getting rid of, yeah, you're gonna do that, I don't mind that. You might be even choice banned into that for all I know. I don't really care. Weakness Policy? No, Steam Engine, that's nice, but we have Weakness Policy. Yeah, there you go. You're gonna be using Solar Beam. Iron Head. I mean, sure. I might try to stop the stream after this match and restart it, just in case there's some buggy things going on. Clear body can't... I love how it can be intimidated in another dimension. We are going to fake out, and we are going to... Yeah, we're gonna fake out and we're gonna take down Dragapult. And hopefully he targeted down Lapras. Nope. That's problematic. Either way, we can get rid of Dragapult at least. Okay, if he has Solar Beam, he can't use it anymore. One turn of grassy terrain. Okay, we're gonna protect. Stall out the grassy terrain for this turn. Because there's going to be no more power up if he were to... Okay, that's fine. He's using Stone Edge. But I still have a... Okay. So all I have to do is just hit the damn Hydro Pump and not die from the plus two super effective attack. That is unlikely. Good game. Well, damn. Well, damn. Oh, well. Good job, Red. And where are we at? That's 11. This is 12. Hey, we're back at neutral. This IVs are really bugging me. I'm on top, El Creamy and Gengar all not having the proper stats is really bad. Oh well. I gotta figure out what to put on the bottom bar though. I can't just do the chat window. I need to have something else there. I guess if I made the team properly, I can have the team code there. If people wanted to check it out, they can always download it. I guess I'd do that, because it'd fill up the little part. I don't know. It's kind of weird. Yeah, we'll do three more, then we're done. Kiboje? Okay, we are going to straight up. Yeah, we're just going to straight up Creamy Lapras. I don't trust the Gengar. Although, actually, no. Clefairy Lapras, Hitmontop. Sucker Punch and other things and shenanigans. And I think Okreme is slow. Unintentionally, but technically. I guess Togekiss wouldn't be a bad bet. Yeah, Togekiss won't be a bad bet. Is there still voice problems? Anyone else? No problems. Weird. Oh wait, I don't have my headphone now. This is a weird setup. It's okay. Check. I should do my first move first anyway. We will G-Max Resonance, and we will Gravity. Oh, if you don't, it might be on your side, Entidus. Oh no, it's one of those things where I can't quite check right now. So, I don't know if they're going for Trick Room or not, but if they're going for Trick Room, they're going to have a bad time. Because Hatterene was really the only Pokemon that could, you know, as long as it's, you know, Magic Bounce. Oops, sorry, that was my wedding ring against the controller, that noise. Ooh, I don't think this... I think this person might be doing this for the... I think this person might be doing this for the shirt kind of thing and just entered a team. Because I don't think there's any strategies for confusion. Oh, well, play every battle like you're versing someone who's a champion. We are going to G-Max Geyser against the Hatterene, and we are going to Sing against the Gengar. Yeah, a lot of people are going to be entering this thing just for the Great Ball Guy shirt. It could have Clear Small, that would have been a lot better to put on than Sludge Bomb. Oh well. There's one turn guaranteed sleep versus Gengar. I did use that. Oh, let's see again. We'll switch out. No. No, we gotta get rid of the Hatterene first. Again, play like always your. I don't care if this person's brand new to the game. I don't care if they've literally only entered just for one match. I will always play as if I'm versing someone who I have like a 0% win rate against. So there's never a reason to slack when you're choosing moves. Hydro Pump versus... Actually, Parish Song and Sing. Again, sorry, I'm not taking any prisoners here. Colossal's extremely annoying if it has Steam Engine. Ah, big Colossal. Or big Sleeping Gengar. One of the two. We don't know. Sandstorm's good because it possibly gets rid of a Focus Sash as well. And Hydro Pump against the Gengar, and we can switch out to Hitmontop. Fun fact, if you ever pay attention to all my matches I've always uploaded, there's always been two things which have always been the case for my Pokeballs. One is all my Weaviles have always come out of a dive ball, and all my Hitmontops have always come out of a heal ball. It's something I've always found amusing to myself that I accidentally started doing that, I just kept it. So, Hydro Pump is disabled.
Okay.
We're just going to switch him out to Tokiss then.
Yep.
And then we're going to Sucker Punch the Gengar. It's just one of those things that I find immediately amusing. Yeah, all the Weaviles, I think even when I gave to Iron, it ends up being a dive ball one as well. So this is bred from the same ones. Fun fact, the last Edmonton tournament we actually had, there was someone who was brand new to the game, and I played exactly like I did right now against them. There's no point pulling punches and making them feel bad. And, you know, good on you for entering a tournament. It's fun. So two more battles. I've done my 15, so I might as well do that. Well, I'll definitely end it. I don't think I'll do day two and day three, because this Alcremie's so fun when it's proper. You know. Ooh, Satakonda. Neat. Okay, so we have some problems here with that Dramanatan. Wayfair redirection, Dramanatan. Okay, so it's gonna probably be Guerrilla Tactics with a Choice Scarf, or Guerrilla Tactics with Redirection Support and a Choice Band. If that's the case, it could basically one-shot everything I have. The Gothitelle and Snorlax and Clefairy doesn't make me want to have a Trick Room idea up for Gengar. So I think I will go about... Yeah. So we're going to do Lapras, and we're going to do Clefairy to hopefully get rid of that darn thing. If not, set up Urveil, and then we'll have him on top and Togekiss in the back. Because like that thing I'm actually extremely afraid of. That's gonna be my stadium, because you can't have a one of the small one. I wish you could. I wish you could have like this regular battle there. Okay, I called that horribly wrong, but we have the exact same lineup, just backwards. So I am going to G-Max Resonance against his Pokemon, and I am going to Gravity. As worst comes to worst, I'm gonna start spamming Sing. And my, if he did Dynamax and do the... Nope. Okay. No redirection, no whatever. Just gonna go straight up for an attack then. Is he gonna use Parish Song? If he uses Parish Song, I found my soul. Oh, it's using Parish Song! Oh, buddy. Parish Song keeps that. Yeah, Lapras is very popular. Especially in best of ones, because it's really hard to get through the bulk in one turn. We're going to be Helping Hand for the first turn, because obviously we don't want Shadow Tag to be a problem. And this is where he's going to Dynamax his own Pokemon, try to get Aurora Veil set up, and stall things out. That's fine. Oh, this team's hilarious. I love the idea of a Shadow Tag Parish Song team with Lapras. Maybe that's what I'll investigate for the next time I do a tournament. Whoever's coming in is going to sleep. Yeah, no redirection. Well, why is it an assault vest, but they used... You can play that game. What a stupid match. What an absolutely dumb and stupid match. Oh, it has a Lumberry too! I have hair song. This is so dumb. I love it. Come on, internet. Don't crap out. I legitimately find this funny. I love this guy's team so much. We will use Air Slash against you. Actually no, we're gonna Dazzling Gleam, and he's gonna use Parasongs no matter what, so I'm gonna have to use Fake Out for the first turn. And most likely it's a Shell Armor one. One more turn of gravity. Hunting down. Yeah, I'm gonna have to potentially use Air Slash and Fake Out. I have to make sure I prevent the use of Parasong as much as possible, and the only way I can do that. Here's obviously the Gothitelle. And hopefully I can get rid of Gothitelle's with the Air Slash. Yeah, I think so. Only thing I can kind of bank on is... like, I'm still in Trick Room, that's the problem. Like, I lost because of that. Because no matter what, Parasong will come out now. But I can try to use Sucker Punch versus the Gothitelle. And hopefully... That's fine. Yeah, here's Parish Song, and here's the winning condition, so GG. I like this guy's team a lot. Like, this is really cool. That's why I love this meta right now. It's so bizarre. Do that again, and... actually, yeah, I'll just Bullet Punch. There's no reason why we can't kill Gothitelle with a Bullet Puncher. Oh, damn it! I meant to target down the Lapras with that. Yeah, do that, and Bullet Punch. Nothing else, I just took down one damn Pokemon. Great team that is. Let's just send this one to Sand Knight later. He absolutely loves Parish teams. I mean, he's gonna protect, so no matter what, I lose, but I might as well go for the most efficient turn, right? Yeah, and there you go, I lose. What a great team. No points to attack anyway. Icing on the cake. And this is actually like, minus the EV spreads, this is actually kind of a my team. Again, built off the Mammal team. Mammal? What was the other one here? I'll post the links in chat. This is the first team which I based it off. Oh, it's fine. Losses are losses. And then I base it off of as well this secondary team. Minus the Toga crits, I kept the Choice Scarf Togekiss. I believe both of them actually have the same Lapras. No, I chose the bulkier one from the Ice Creamy team. Or the first link. I took away Incineroar and Conkeldurr for Gengar. I might remove Gengar and put down Conkeldurr again because he was a lot of fun. I tried to change up this team. And I changed up, one sec, there's a third team that's missing here. It's Trainer Tower. Oh, Speed Tiers. Pokemon BGC 2020 teams, and it's the Trainer Tower link. No, sorry, Victory Road. And then I base the Alcremie off of... Can I just open up? Yeah, cool. I base off the Alcremie and the team off this one. And I get why Gengar is supposed to do the whole Sludge Wave thing to activate the weakness policy, but it does like 40% damage against Alcremie, and I didn't feel good about that. But I get it. At the same time, you can set it up and sweep, but again, you should have, you know, a properly IV Pokemon before doing that. We'll do Battle Tower for the final one. Yeah, so like those are the three things I base this team off of. So I download them, checked out the IVs and EVs and stuff like that. Jaren. Okay, we'll just share. Jaren is doing this for the thing. But whatever. We will do Alcremie, Hitmontop, Togekiss, and Clefairy. Yeah, the one with Incineroar is the ice creamy team I used when I hosted that tournament with the Edmonton people. That's the one I used 100%. That's the one that I think you're the only one that actually kind of beat. And I think, did I beat Patrick or did Patrick beat me? I can't remember. Either way. Ooh, shiny, shiny. This person only has 5 Pokemon on the team. Frisk, no Prankster, don't have to worry about that. So I can straight up Max Flare and Bullet Punch. Yeah, I know you beat that team. You were my final match. You just decimated me with your team. It was great. And next weekend, or the weekend after, depending on university, because my final for my university is on the 20th for chemistry. So I might hold it off till the next weekend after, but I plan to make a more open tournament, not just for our Alberta group. And I got a bunch of shinies I can use as prizes. So we'll go with that. I will probably be adjusting my team a lot. Yeah, that's fine. It's gonna be switched out anyway. Because of the... I love eject button hit on top. It's so much fun. Togekiss here. With whatever comes in after this turn, because I'm pretty sure I'm gonna be able to take out the Rillaboom here. Yeah. We will see what comes in, and I'll base what the choice attack will be on. It's a shame that I forgot to do the IVs, or else I'd be happy to do days 2 and 3. At the same time, I also have a final on the 16th, and I should maybe study more on it. Ooh, hey, Spirit Break's kind of annoying. Sure. Yeah, one step from Eden has been a lot of fun for me as well. I managed to beat the shopkeeper, and I managed to actually find my name in the credits as well. If you get to the end, you can see my name in the credits if you're quick enough. Alright, we are going to do G-Max Finale, and we are going to do Air Slash. You pick a fight with her, you keep attacking her, eventually she gets pissed. And if you do, prepare for a fight. It's easier to beat her on level 0, but there's an achievement for beating her at level 4 and onwards. Oh man, she can absolutely wreck you. And don't fight her at level 6 because she has 9,000 health. It's really hard to get rid of her if you don't have Reva. Even without that, though. But yeah, we got the Choice Scarf. Possible flinch for Inteleon? No. Inteleon is still gonna snipe us with that. Yeah, there goes Grimmsnarl. Although it was a G-Max Grimmsnarl, actually, so that would have been G-Max Snooze. And we get the HP back because I absolutely love Alcremie. Actually, I should look it up now because I'm done my matches. Alcremie, Cerebee. What's his base special attack again? Yeah, 110. So, like, it's still really, really, really strong. We will do Emax Finale and Air Slash. Person has shiny 3 starters, so. Yeah, there's a problem with that, right? We get the flinch against the Cinderace. Yeah, no, G-Max, oh, creamy. It just looks so, so nice. That's choiced. There's no way in the world. Oh, wait, it's, no, the sun's up. Never mind. I was gonna say, there's no way in the world that would be somehow assisted. I mean, yeah. Still physical based, and I can still. Like, I've already used up the. Okay, so here's the other thing you can do with this team, which I never actually got to show off. I'm kind of happy I can a little bit here. Is you can decorate the Hitmontop on the turn it comes in to use Fake Out. So, yay, get the flinch, but then you decorate, then you spam Sucker Punch. So all of a sudden, Sucker Punch becomes extremely dangerous, and they can't ignore it. And then just Dazzling Gleam and Sucker Punch. Like, decorate's so much fun. There you go. I never got to do that in the other games because he was always like one turn away from dying or there's two Pokemon out. But if you have a chance to set it up, it's a lot of fun to do. Good job, Jaren. Good game. I don't think I lost too many. I know I lost a lot because of, you know, problematic things. But actually, let's cancel out of the tournament. So I can fix these Pokemon and I'll make a... not participate. I don't want to do a match. Okay. No. Okay. I can't change it yet. And that's kind of annoying. But I'm not going to be doing the other ones, but I'll take the current standing, stuff like that. That's really cool. I will post to Twitter, and I'll post it obviously in the Facebook group and stuff like that. My team, when this is done, people want to test it out. But I forgot about the IVs. I'm just to take another look at that again. I'll show you. I love being in Chester. I love the music. But we have... These are all the, I have a lot of Pokemon teams that I don't use yet. This one in particular is the one which is the most disappointing, but one of the most effective teams I have. I remade everything, then went, don't like it. But it uses a Venusaur, and you have to basically guarantee sleep powders in the sun. And you use Incineroar to set up the sun. Really bizarre. So yeah, we have Lapras, who's been hyper-trained. Sea Fairy, I don't mind the pretty good speed, but it's supposed to be like, supposed to be relaxed nature and like zero, but I don't really care. The Focus Sash isn't really gonna like make a difference with the decent defense. Like he still can take the special defensive stuff, but I don't like the Sludge Wave on him. Like I get it, Sludge Wave and Alcremie is really good, but yeah, I honestly would have put Icy Wind on, or something along those lines, instead of Sludge Wave, and then you can have Sludge Wave, or sorry, Shadow Ball, Icy Wind, Trick Room, so then if things got too problematic, or you're reversing a Trick Room team, you could straight up reverse it. Togekiss, it's just there for spamming, or using Trick to put Choice Scarf onto the other Pokemon. It's really fun. Alcremie, no more to be said. Unfortunately, Gel, I limb literally ending. Thank you for the raid, though. The bagel has arrived. I can do a few more matches, but just... Yeah, don't worry, I'll do some more matches, but I'm done the tournament matches, so I'll do some matches for you. Don't worry. And then Hitmontop, a decent. Again, I didn't. I'm just pointing out. I'd never IV corrected my Pokemon, the Alcremie and stuff like that. Really good. It's a really fun team. I'll do a couple rank bat matches. I'll do a couple rank matches because I'm at 3 hours right now for the video. Or to upload to YouTube. We'll end that there. So anyone watching on YouTube when this is uploaded, thanks for watching.